Hey, what's going on, guys? It is Lazens here, and it's about time for another video. Now, I am trying to get on some sort of like a weekly upload schedule, like once a week, because I know currently I'm not in the place where I can do a daily upload. All right, well, I'm editing this now, and I'm just gonna cut out the whole next part of this intro because I did a shit job at explaining what I meant. I was saying that currently I have to do a bi-weekly upload schedule because I was about to go stay at my dad's for a few. That's it. That's all I needed to say, but I couldn't get the words bi-weekly out of my mouth. So I'm trying to go weekly so I don't go another 7 months without uploading. This is going to be another PS4 video involving SaveWizard. What I'm going to be teaching you is how to get modded outfits on PS4 SaveWizard. So let's go ahead and get right into the video. Okay, so again, what I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you go to SaveWizard.net. So once it loads, there are two versions of SaveWizard. Now, once again, you are going to need to get the $60 version so you can have advanced mode. So it shows you the differences here. If you get PS4 Max, which is $60, you have access to advanced mode and user entered cheats. You need those. You cannot have the regular edition. If you have the regular edition, I'm not sure if there's an upgrade key. I doubt it. So you are kind of screwed until you get the new version. Now you get two profiles on this version, which means you could also do this for a buddy if you want. So, first things first, what I need you to do is go onto your PlayStation. Once you're on your PlayStation, what you want to do is you want to go to settings. From settings, you want to go down to application saved data management. Then you want to go to save data in system storage. You want to go to copy to a USB storage device, then Grand Theft Auto 5. Now you need to go all the way to the bottom and grab your Franklin and Lamar save. Now you should have one because it's required to go online unless you overwrite your save. If you did, just go back and play the first two missions. That simple. Now you want to select it, copy it, and apply to all and copy it over to your USB drive. Now I already have a save, so I'm not going to be doing that currently. So the next thing you're going to want to do is unplug your USB storage device and go over to your computer. Okay, so once you're on your computer, what you want to do is you want to go to SaveWizard. So once you get to this screen, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to create a profile. All you have to do is go to settings, profile manager, and set up your profile. Then you want to double tick this arrow here. So once you get to here, you might have to register the save with your profile. This one is mine. So right click it and press advanced mode and just wait until it pops up with a bunch of numbers. That is the hex editor. So once you're here, what you're going to want to do is download the file from the description, and what it's going to take you to is a list of GTA save files. So once you're on this website, you're just going to want to scroll down, and based on whether you have a female character or a male character, you just want to download the saves. Oh damn, they added a new outfit. This outfit's actually sick. Okay, I'm going to download this one because this is fire. You want to click where it says decrypted file, and I have a download manager, so I'm going to download it through that, but it should just automatically start downloading. So what you're going to do from there is exit out of Chrome, and you are going to want to press import file. Now you want to go to your downloads folder and find the save you've just downloaded. I accidentally downloaded two, and then press open, apply, yes, and just wait for it to finish. So now that it's finished, it's going to pop up saying modification successfully applied. You want to press OK and close SaveWizard. And now all you want to do, open up File Explorer. Don't just pull out the USB because that can damage it. And then you want to go to your USB drive, show more options if you're in Windows 11, eject. So now it's ejected, unplug it and put it back into your PlayStation. Okay, so what you're going to want to do from here is you're going to want to go up to settings once you have put your USB stick back into your computer. You are going to want to go down to the same thing, application save data management, but instead of going to save data in system storage, you want to go to save data on USB storage device. Copy to system storage, Grand Theft Auto 5, select, go down to copy, apply to all, yes. Now you want to go back to your home screen, just load up GTA. So once you're in story mode, it should look about like this. And what you want to do is you want to go to online, play GTA online, invite only session, and just wait for it to load. Okay, so as you can see, I'm spawning in. Now, before you do this glitch, make sure you don't have a parachute enabled at this point. Like, make sure you don't have one on your player. If you do, go in and use it so you get rid of it. because when you spawn in, it will replace the duffel bag with a parachute bag instead, and you do not want that. So what we're going to do from here is drive over to a time trial, and unlike with the frozen money glitch, there's no like pausing or a step you should watch preemptively. Like, you can all just listen along and do it. So you want to start the time trial, press down on your D-pad, and then select Michael, because otherwise you could spawn in as Franklin and it'll just ruin the glitch. You have to spawn in as Michael, and this is the only way to 100% guarantee that will happen. Okay, so once you're spawned in as Michael, you just want to start walking. It'll be a glitched out Michael, and you're going to appear as Franklin, and you just want to sprint forward, like just like count to five while you're running forward. And the moment, as you can see, I can see the duffel bag. The moment you can see Michael again, select Michael. Down the D-pad, select Trevor. And then once you're Trevor, you want to hold down on the D-pad and select to switch to Michael. Okay. Now you're going to switch back to Michael. And then once you're Michael, you're going to want to go to another invite-only session. Now you cannot use the D-pad or it will bug out. You want to select an invite-only session. So I'm now Michael. Pause. Online. Play GTA Online. Invite-only session. Okay. And now I will be back once I'm in an online session. Okay, so I'm about to spawn in. Now, what you're going to want to do is either call a Deluxo or any sort of helicopter so you can get a duffel bag. Oh, fuck. It gave me a parachute because I was on my oppressor. No. Fuck. Okay, also to show you what you can do from here. So what you're going to want to do from here is just call any helicopter, whether it has to be through Pegasus or if you have one owned. So I'm just going to call my buzzard. Sorry, my down on my D-pad is pretty fidgety, so I have to like scroll perfectly. There we go. And now that my buzzard is here, what you're gonna wanna do is fly to the mask shop. Okay, so I'm approaching the mask shop now. We are almost there. I just have to get a little bit farther. And what you're gonna wanna do is hover not directly above the mask shop. You wanna go out by the coastal line and then jump out and use your parachute. So this is definitely high enough. I'm gonna jump from about here, and you're gonna wanna try and land at the t-shirt stand. Oh, there. So if you got it like this, if you have a duffel bag on, you will still have it now. It'll be in the back, and all you're going to want to do is save your outfit. And then you are done with this glitch. You now have a modded SaveWizard outfit. And yeah, if you guys did enjoy, make sure to like and subscribe. I do hope you enjoyed this tutorial. And yeah, this is going to be Lazens. Peace.